Welcome to another Working Out with Aaron Briggs video. Today, what are we doing?
Yeah, today is gonna be cardio. We've got about 15 minutes coming your way. If we combine our warm up plus our, you know, it's about a 12 minute circuit here. And as we normally do, we're gonna begin with warming up by doing the movements that you're gonna do for the exercises today, just a kind of a simpler and shorter version of that. So if you'd like to join us, the first thing we're doing is what's called our frog movement or our frog hops. And I get to introduce my little helper today. This is our five, almost 6 year old Lucy. And she's a special guest star because the last time we did a video with our animal movements, she begged and begged to be able to do the next one. Mm-hmm. It's like, this is what I was made for. So she gets to join us today, and you'll see her doing lots of enthusiastic hops and bear walks and other things. And that brings us to our second movement, which is a bear walk. And again, if you're doing these for the first time, you're in that high push-up position, maybe doing kind of a down dog if you've done some yoga, and you're really just walking around on your hands and your feet. Pardon me. Okay, and our third movement coming up is what's called a monkey move or a side shuffle. And the movement here is really, it's like a squat, but you're moving around side to side. And what I want to promise you is sometimes these animal movements can feel a little bit silly. We'll get into why we do them in a little bit. But I also want you to know that there are lots of variations that we can do that aren't quite so animal specific and maybe don't feel quite so foreign to you. And so we'll talk about where you can find those in the meantime. But right now, just think you're really looking at doing kind of a sideways or a lateral movement with that monkey move. Yeah. And then last of all, we're gonna do our crab position or a crab walk. So again, think back to middle school, elementary school, when you probably had to do this in gym at some point. And, you know, dig back into it.
Elementary school, probably yeah. Second grade, right?
Okay, and so at any rate, with the crab position, again, if you're slightly uncomfortable with it, if you have wrists that hurt, keep in mind that the basic move there is probably a bridge. It's something where, you know, you're picking your hips up and maybe even doing a small press and getting those triceps working, okay? So a quick heads up, we're getting ready to start here. If you're uncomfortable with the animal movements, okay? When we start our timer, which is gonna happen in about 3 seconds, 2, 1, you can start with those frog hops. If you're thinking, I don't really wanna do this, go ahead and fast forward the video until it says 4 minutes on that timer in the upper left-hand corner. Then you'll start seeing the variations that I'll show you. And you can rewind it and start over if you wanna see the timer, you know, once you know what you're gonna do, or just pick up from where we did it, you know, kind of do your own thing. The goal, what we're gonna do for people who love the roadmap is four movements, each one about 60 seconds long. There's no break today because we're trying to do cardio, right? We're trying to keep it going.
Keep that heart rate going.
And we're
gonna
go 3 rounds. So all in all, it's about 12 minutes of straight timer time and about 15 minutes total, including that warm up.
Yeah. Okay?
So again, right now you're doing those frog hops or squats and you're really just getting a feel for it, making sure that it looks and feels good. And
yeah. And Aaron, I see you doing, you did a hop at first and now you're just doing kind of a front and back step.
Yeah.
Small steps at a time.
Three, so, two, one. It was a variation. It was dialing back down. That made it a little more realistic for some people. Okay. Exercise number two is a bear walk.
The bear walks are something that our kids do all the time. And basically it's just getting your four kind of limbs down on the ground and then walking. It's seriously, like Aaron said, you don't have to worry about your form. You don't have to worry about kind of the technicalities of it at all. Just really just kind of walking around with your butt up in the air and
or not.
Yeah. My bear walk, as I get more tired, sometimes my legs are a little more bent. Just like Lucy's are, you can see that she's doing a bear walk as well. But, it's really just kind of moving around. You can do it sideways. You can do it front to back. And that is one of the ways that you are gonna just feel kind of all the muscles in your body working all at one time.
Five
it's kind
seconds.
Of a fun way to work your body out.
3, 2, 1, let's try that monkey shuffle. And again, if this is a little too much on your hips and your knees, just think sideways movement here. It could be
right.
A side step, it could be a little side shuffle. And again, in later
could
rounds,
be a side
I'll show
lunge.
You that. Side lunge,
yep.
Absolutely. Okay, so you know, I mentioned we'd get into the why. Maggie always loves asking me the question, why do we do these animal movements? What is it about this?
Because I know you always have an answer.
Absolutely, right? There's
you
a reason.
You always have a reason why.
So the reason why I like doing these animal movements and why I recommend them for people is it gets to the root of it, our basic movements, right? We're doing squats, we're doing deadlifts, we're doing forward movements, backward movements, we're using our arms and our legs to push and pull. And so it's not unlike the strength workouts that we do. When we make kind of a movement like this though, it also adds in the idea of mobility. You're kind of challenging your body to move in a slightly different way. Yeah, thank you for the countdown. We'll pause that thought for just a second. Four,
we don't want to
miss the countdown. 2, 1, and crab walk, please, or your crab position. Mm-hmm. So yeah, picking up that thought, it's when you're combining a couple of things like strength movements and mobility, it can make the workout a little more challenging, but it also gets you prepared to do things a little different. It allows your body to adapt and to get stronger, to get more flexible, to get more mobile. Sometimes when we just add a little complexity to things.
Yeah, so, because in everyday life, we're not thinking, when we pick something up, we're not thinking, oh, I'm going to get into my squat position or my deadlift position. We really kind of move faster than what we think about sometimes. Right. And I've noticed too, like that's sometimes when I end up hurting myself, is when I kind of reach for something the wrong way or lift up something in a different way. And this is a way to help us prevent injuries.
Absolutely.
And also just kind of stay young. It's like those get ups and get downs. It's really a way for us to move the way we're supposed to move.
Four.
Look at Lucy doing this. It's crazy.
2, 1. Okay, first round done. Congratulations. Woo-hoo! If you're ready.
Yeah, woo.
Let's go.
Breathe that heavy, probably. Maybe.
Let's get into round 2. And again, the idea here is to do that kind of basic squat movement. So the version that I'm doing right now is what we call a squat to stretch. And it's fantastic, right? When I'm sitting my butt down towards the ground, I'm getting into a kind of a deep squat. It happens to be a stretch. I'm keeping my hands near the ground as I try to stand back up. I'm feeling the stretch through my hamstrings. It's largely a mobility exercise, but while I'm doing it, I felt it in my thighs.
I'm sure.
You know, I mean, it's absolutely, you're having to use your muscles to stand up.
I'm always curious, do my hands need to be, your hands are inside your knees, do they have to be inside or outside, or does it matter?
Go with what's comfortable. And your hands don't even have to be on the ground. Some people will do this, and I tell them to hold their shins.
Great.
You know, just,
okay.
And the
even
idea
touching
is,
their knees maybe,
even touching
right?
their knees,
okay.
yeah. You don't have to get as low as I am. You don't have to do anything that we're doing here. The idea is make it work for you.
Lucy's still doing the frog hops for you though, guys.
2, 1. Let's get into that bear walk. Okay, now it's round 2. And remember, our intention for round 2 is always just to make it a little bit better. So play around with your form, play around with what exactly you want to do. This time, I played around with doing some kind of in-place bear walks. I had to manage Lucy going under to me, which absolutely makes for a different exercise. I kept my butt up in the air, and you can see I'm really just marching in place, right? I'm doing what I call going around the world. Mm. One arm, the other arm, one leg, the other leg, just kind of playing around with it. I'm going to go out into what we call a high plank position here and do that same going around the world. I might, you know, pick up an arm and a leg at the same time. And the idea with a bear walk is that it's still just a push. And so whatever you're choosing to do in that push category, make it a little bit better. Be proud of your form, be mindful of it. If you've done those things, you're right where you need to be.
Yeah.
Trust in the process.
7 seconds here, guys.
Yeah, trust in the process to make it feel like a workout. It'll get you there. 3, 2, 1. Next up is our monkey move, or if you're choosing to do something a little different, the sideways position. And here, you're gonna see me doing a deadlift where I just put my hands to one side and then I walk my feet over to my hands and then I stand up again.
Yeah.
And again,
it's great.
I have the flexibility to be able to touch the ground, but if you don't, that's fine. Really, bend over, put your hands at knee level, and then walk sideways and stand up again, right?
Yeah.
That's a very simple way to do this if you're new to it. You can have a little more fun and really just move well here.
Yeah.
Again, no matter what you're doing, aim to make it feel good, to make it look good, and then dial it up a little bit. When you stand up tall and proud.
Wally, our 6-month-old, just said hi to you guys. So.
Yeah, 15 more seconds here. Keep rolling.
And even though there's no weights involved with this workout, you are still getting stronger and you are improving your body with this workout.
Exactly. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's try that crab position. Nice job so far. 7 minutes in without a break. That's significant cardio.
Yeah,
you're moving here.
Yeah, you're killing it, you guys. Way to go.
Yep. Okay. Now, I talked about this in the first round, but the idea with a crab walk is twofold. You get to use your hips, your glutes, your butt muscles to push up. And so if you wanted to break it down into its parts, just do a bridge for right now, right? That's totally fine. to just raise your hips up and down. I promise you that you're still getting a workout here.
Mm-hmm.
And what I always like to tell people when it comes to cardio is that cardio doesn't always have to feel really, really challenging,
yeah.
right? Strength workouts, yes, we need a little more challenge, but cardio workouts just don't have to be that way. Now, one thing that I'm gonna show you here, right? I said it's two parts with that crab. There's a bridge and then there's the lifting, right? The kind of that tricep press. And now you're seeing me do that. I'm at the base, just lifting my body up off the ground. And if I wanted to really throw those hips in there, I would also do kind of that high bridge. 3, 2, 1. Excellent job. 2 complete rounds down. You've got 1 more round, 4 more minutes to go. If you need that reminder, we're doing your frog hops or squats. In this particular time, I'm gonna show you a squat. And then with 30 seconds to go, we're gonna do the dialed up version, which is adding a little jump. Now, before you do or even think about doing jumps, remember, they're optional. Some people do not react well to jumps for internal reasons, for external reasons, so if it's not your jam, don't do it. Just keep doing your squats or do your hops. Or sorry, do your squats or your little frog movement anywhere there, okay?
Do you think Lucy was getting tired yet?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
She was. But she was having fun, right? And the idea I told her was the same thing I tell everyone is, hey, do what you can do. If you need to take breaks, take breaks. And one of our favorite things to do, I personally love adding a little bit of jumping because it falls into that same category Maggie was talking about. Sometimes you have to move a little quickly. Sometimes
yeah.
you have to be able to absorb a little shock. And jumps are great ways to practice that. So again, if it's in your wheelhouse, if you feel safe enough, try it. Okay, last time doing our version of a bear walk, one of my favorite exercises and substitutions is what we call a shoulder tap. This is where you're in plank position. You can be on your feet or your knees, either one will work. And then you're just reaching up and tapping the opposite shoulder. And when you do that, you're having to balance. You're really working your strength on one side of your body, especially if you're trying not to rotate. And for the second half here, I'm doing the exact same thing just with my feet. I suppose not the exact same thing. I'm not tapping my shoulders.
Yeah. That you'd be in like a circus.
I would be
in like Cirque du Soleil.
A different skill set. Yeah.
But
again, the idea here is you're just really experimenting with how your body moves. And I think one of the key parts to doing these animal movements or even just playing around with these kinds of things is the idea of play, being playful.
Yeah.
4, 3, 2, 1. You've got that monkey move or again, kind of that shuffle or deadlift. And you see me, we've done these before. This is one of my favorite movements for at-home workouts for body weight deadlifts. These are just great. But yeah, when I'm doing these kinds of workouts, I smile most of the time because it's a little silly, it's a little fun. And that's what we're hoping for here is for you to be able to have, you know, a little joy in your movement here. And if it's too silly for you to be able to have joy, then back it off, you know?
Right,
kinda
yeah.
Do
it's
what
not,
you need to
just
do.
Just like Aaron gave us options, it's not quite, we know that we have a little bit of a different attitude than some other people might. And so we want to make everybody feel safe during these workout videos. And so that's why we give you lots of options. And one of our main parts of all of our movements is look good and feel good. Feel good doing
it. Which means safe.
Yeah. Oh, hi, Wally. Oh, thank you. Wally
says
hi.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do that crab walk. Last minute of the exercise session. Go ahead and have some fun here. Now, this version is kind of tying together some of what we talked about in the last times with those crabs. It's a toe touch from the crab position. And this is not a crab. This is something that if you go to gyms, you will see people doing this. This is a great core move.
Yeah.
And you're up. It requires some balance, a little bit of flexibility. At the halfway point, you'll see me kind of breaking it down into its parts here. I'll start going around the world. And a creative solution you can do is instead of reaching forward and touching that toe is reach forward or reach up to the sky like I'm gonna do here. Try it with your hands, try it with your toes. Again, you can reach forward, you can reach up, play around with it, but it's like doing those planks or shoulder taps. You're on only 3 points of contact and it changes changes the way you move. It changes how you're supporting
yourself.
You're
engaging your core differently and all that,
Exactly. 4, 3, 2, 1, and you are done. Congratulations.
Ooh.
12 minutes on the clock.
Oh, wow.
About
way to
15
go, you
minutes
guys.
Total with that warm up. You did
shaking
that
it out with Lucy, right?
We do our little shake it out. We love it.
Good job, you guys. Oh, that was awesome. Well, we invited the rest of our kiddos out to do a couple of these movements too. This is, again, something that we just love doing very playfully. You can see it's very chaotic, not organized at all with our kids when we invite them into it, because we keep it fun and we'd never even call it a workout. We just call it playing. You guys, this was one of our cardio videos. It was 15 minutes long. We have lots of other videos that are 10 minutes, 5 minutes, 20 minutes, 25 minutes. Please subscribe to our channel if you are interested in getting in moving around with us more. We just want to invite you in and hang out with you and move with you, have some fun. Make it a great day.